So what would be a piece of information that, if we knew it, would make it relatively straightforward to figure out, you know, what new state we were in?
Well, if we knew which state we were in before, since we have a transition model, we know which states we are likely to be in next.
Yeah. Okay. Well, let's just write that. That's a really good start. So what we're saying is, let's break things down by the possible state that we started in, and what we want to know, and we're going to weight things by, well, what's the probability that that's the state we started in, given BAZ. Then, given that, what's the probability of the next state, given that state? So this is going to help us break things down successfully. So let's see if we can do that. So what do we know about the probability of being in a state, given a belief state that we took an action and we made some observation? So I think that the thing to point out here is that the observation that we're going to that we saw is generated by the state that we ended up in. And so we're actually trying to figure out what state we were in based on the observation we got, when in fact the generative model goes the other way. So this is a prime situation to try to use Bayes' rule.
Prime.
It's an S prime situation for using Bayes' rule. So that gives us the probability of making an observation given the state that we're in, or that we arrived in S prime, and carrying over the A and the S. And the probability that that's the state we ended in, given A and S, divided by the normalization factor, the probability of the observation given A and S.
Right.
All right, so now we're getting really close to quantities that we recognize. In particular, the probability of an observation given the state that we just landed in is independent of the action and the state that we just took.
Mm-hmm.
So this is going to be the observation function. This right here is the transition function, the probability of landing in some state S prime given that we were in state S and took action A. And then this is just going to be a normalization factor at the bottom.
Right.
So substituting those quantities in and rewriting out this normalization factor as basically the numerator divided by the sum of all the possible next states S prime, we get one component of the new belief state B prime. If we apply the same idea over all possible states S prime, then we get a probability distribution over all the states that represents the likelihood of being in those states given that we were in belief state B, took action A, and made observation Z.
Oh, so that's intuitively obvious even to the most casual observer. But more importantly, it just uses all the quantities we already had.
It does. It seems like sort of a, you know, like when a TV series is over and they bring all the characters back for one last show. It's like, you know, we got the B back and the O back and the Z back. Everybody's friends again.
And it spells bot.
And it spells bot. So my point is that these quantities can be easily calculated from, or sorry, this quantity, this B prime S prime, can be easily calculated from quantities that we have lying around, because we have the model of the POMDP, and we know what the previous belief state is, and we know what action we just took and what observation we made. And so all this can be updated. And so we can keep track of kind of this notion of where we are, this belief state notion of the belief MDP.
I like it.
Cool. All right. So this doesn't actually tell us how to do decision making, because all we've done actually is we turned a POMDP into an MDP that, by the way, has an infinite number of states. So we can we have a number of algorithms that we can run, like linear programming or policy iteration or value iteration, and they all at best grow polynomial in the number of states, so it's polynomial in infinity. So infinity.
So it's a constant.
Yeah, no, it's bigger than any constant. So this is problematic. We can't just take this MDP now that we've defined it and just solve it using our existing algorithms. We're going to have to be a little bit more careful. And so I want to step through the algorithmic process for how you can actually do that. It's kind of nice, I think.
Okay. I mean, I can't wait to see how you make infinity. So let's do it.